Hey there, Lisa, your stylist from Salon Uptown Downtown in beautiful downtown Bradenton, Florida, with your sparkle point of the day. A lot of times people ask me about flat ironing their own hair. I don't know if you can tell, mine's pretty curly, kinky. Today, it's humid, so it's really frizzy. The problem most people have when flat ironing their own hair is they take too big of a section, so their hair is left with quite a bit of wave. So I recommend taking a clip of any kind, gator clip, regular hair clip, whatever you have at home. Don't have to buy anything special, and clip your hair up. So I'm going to start at the bottom and I'm going to take a very small section. And clip the rest out of my way. I have fine hair. And I am using the Paul Mitchell Neuro 1 inch, 1 inch, 1.5 inch flat iron. And I'm going to comb through my hair. And that's probably about a 4 inch wide section. So I'm gonna do half and half. And I'm gonna get as close to my scalp as I possibly can without burning myself, and just pulling it through slowly. And you have to go over more than once, so probably a good 4 passes on each section. I've lost count because I was babbling, but 1, 2, 3. Yeah, 4 looks like it should do it. And I'm just gonna continue on through my head, dropping down a little bit each time. So my next section, clip the rest up out of my way again, and comb through. I used a thermal heat protectant prior to turning on the video camera. I apologize. We are a Paul Mitchell salon, so I of course used the Paul Mitchell Hot Off the Press. Good product. And this section's a little wider, so I'll probably do this in 3 sections. And I did a couple extra passes because I could see that close here had a kink in it. And, you know, you don't have to slide it, the flat iron, down right away as soon as you put your hair in. You can hold it there for a few seconds, which is what I do right at the scalp. Because if you have curly hair, generally you have a kink right there at the scalp. So by holding it there, you're just forcing that heat into the curl. But it's, you know, it doesn't have to take forever. Some people feel like it takes forever to flat iron their hair, and it doesn't need to. And I guess if you take a section, a subsection of what you've divided, it about 2 inches wide should be perfect all the way around. But you can see as my pass goes through, it's kind of slow because I'm just really getting the heat in there good. My flat iron is set to 390 degrees, which is the fine hair setting. This flat iron has thermal settings up to 450 degrees. So for that thick coarse hair, you know, they would need the flat iron a little hotter. And just kind of take your hand and feel where you can't see to feel that it's smooth. And if you feel a bump or a crimp in it, then just, you know, go over that section again where you feel the difference. So this is just the basics of flat ironing your hair. You know, so often I get a novice in the salon, or even just people meet me and find out I'm a hairdresser and ask, well, how do you do this? And how do you do that? So I am now able to share this YouTube channel with them and they can get the basic idea from there. And I'm just going to smooth down my fringe. And that will be good for just basic flat ironing. Kind of combing through it. Now, can I turn so you can see the back? Hopefully that was great. Here's looking at you. Hope you're feeling fabulous and you too can flat iron your own hair.